So I'm going to show you how to put a latex skin on foam that you've carved into a shape. Here I have a block of foam. I haven't done anything to the surface, and I've applied a layer of latex about the thickness of a dime to it. I just spread it around with my finger after pouring it onto the surface. You can apply it however you want. While that's drying for the next 4 hours, I've placed paint in a disposable container, and I'm going to mix that with my latex. So we'll talk about coloring latex. When you mix your latex and your paint, it's not going to look like it will when it dries. This is forest green before it dries. Notice that in mixing, I've introduced air bubbles into it, even though I've tried to mix carefully. Shaking is terrible. It will introduce lots of bubbles. So I've gone through and individually popped the worst of the offending bubbles. Then I've sucked up the latex into a syringe and made veins on a piece of tinfoil. I like the tinfoil because I can peel it away from the latex really easily, but any smooth surface will do. So, 4 hours later, I've applied one of the veins to my base coat of latex. You can add several base coats. I'm only adding one base coat and one colored coat. So now I've added my colored coat. The same way I mixed a tiny batch for the veins, I've mixed a larger batch for the colored coat, and I've inserted a vein into the top, embedding it into the wet latex to compare effects. So, now I let it dry overnight, and here's what we've got. A latex skin. You can see the thin spots where the color from the base layer is shown through. The problem is it's sticking to itself. It doesn't spring back very quickly, and it's making those nasty folds, so we have to treat the surface of the latex. And that's easy enough. By using talcum powder, and then spreading it around the surface, the latex will no longer stick to itself, and as long as you take care of your appliance or your skin or whatever by talcuming it once in a while, it'll last for a really long time. So I've wiped away the excess talc, and now it's nice and springy. It's not sticking to itself, and it's not forming any sort of weird lines. So that's how you would make a latex skin without a mold over some foam. Let's take a close-up look at the veins for adding texture to the skin that you'd usually get by making a sculpture with a mold. So here's our vein under the colored layer. You can see it peeking through. That's kind of a neat effect. And here's a vein that's been put on after the second coat of latex dried overnight, just stuck on top. And thirdly, here's the vein that was inserted into the wet layer of latex and then pressed down. So those are some possible effects for adding features to your skin.